You're in the Business Insurance Zone with me, Steve Savant, syndicated financial columnist and contributor to Backroom Technician. This week on The Biz, the Disability Insurance for Business series, our tribute to Disability Awareness Month, May 2013. And on today's show, recognized expert Dan Steenerson.
When it comes to life insurance, annuities, long-term care, disability, or group pension plans, we're the news you can use.
Well, welcome everyone to the Business Insurance Zone. I'm your host, Steve Savant, and of course, we're broadcasting to a nationwide audience of financial advisors right here in Fountain Hills, Arizona, home of America's largest fountain. And with me today, they call him D.I. Dan. I mean, Dan Steenerson, top authority in disability insurance, recognized throughout the country, and major author. Well, thank you for coming to the
show, Dan. Thank you, Steve. My pleasure.
I got to tell you, Dan, you know, I've read your stuff. You're all over the web. You're Mr. Blog. You're Mr. Anything that's DI. You're talking about it, writing about it. Now you're on our show talking about it. Last week, we had Marcy on. She did a great job on individual DI. But yes. I want to introduce everybody that's watching our show today to Business DI. That's our day-to-day. We're here to sell the rest of the week today. And everybody thinks about, I want to get in front of business clients. I mean, that's the goal. It's the holy grail of marketing. But we all look the same. We're all trying to do 401ks. We're all trying to sell life insurance. We're trying to do this. Bringing in disability is really distinctive. Talk a little bit about why this is such a play and how it could build out your business.
Well, I thank you very much for the question. It's a great question. You know, we really do believe it's the forgotten sale. Very often, a producer will go in and they will sell the other products that you had mentioned before, but they forget about the disability product. Mm-hmm. And I think part of that is because they're confused, or maybe they're not settled, or maybe even unsettled in selling that type of a product when they don't have the education or the understanding behind it.
Well, I think some of our viewers, and I have to put myself in there as well, you know, I have a very good general practice, but this is not my area. So when I think about it, I say, wow, do I have to be an attorney to read these legalese and what the definitions are of claims? And am I going to get in the minutiae of legal language that I can't talk about?
Yeah, that's absolutely a concern of many producers. Not only that, once they do understand the product itself, how do I make that product from a practical standpoint fit with my client's needs? And that's generally a real hard issue for them to overcome.
When I'm walking into business, do you think, I mean, because a lot of people like to lead, no matter what the product line is, no matter what their plan is, if there's a way to tax deduct it, that seems to be the holy grail of walking into a business person and saying, I have some ideas, and part of that package is the tax advantages. Is that a play for what we're talking about for DI?
I really do think it is. It's one of the many different plays that are out there. First and foremost, going after the business owner marketplace does allow you to spend daytime activity rather than sitting at a kitchen table at midnight with some other client. So that's a really good thing. The other thing is this, is the deductibility part of that. You know, the business owner can find that they can actually have their cake and eat it too by deducting the premiums, and in some cases with some products actually have the benefits tax-free.
So they can do both the deduction and the benefit-free?
Absolutely.
Well, we're going to have to get into that.
We will.
That's
going to certainly will.
That's an area I want to talk about. Well, when I'm walking in, I'm thinking about, and we talked about this last week with Marcy, hey, we've identified rainmakers in our business, or people we're trying to attract to join our firm using disability as a major benefit. And it is a major rainmaker. If you're trying to acquire a player, this is a huge benefit. And if you're trying to retain people into your organization, this is a good benefit ongoing. If you're walking into an employer who's headhunting for a person right now, how do you tell them how important DI is to his high payroll exec?
Absolutely. Good question. Well, I think first and foremost, you have to understand what the objectives are of the business. For example, we had a company in San Diego that actually hired a president that would take this company, pharmaceutical company, through its IPO. They were concerned what would happen if in the event that this president became disabled and what was the only person that had that experience could not bring him through the IPO. We suggested key person. Mm-hmm. That made a whole lot of sense to the business itself.
But you didn't suggest key person life insurance, which I think would be the knee-jerk reaction of a lot of our producers. You actually did DI.
That's correct, yes.
And we're going to talk about business succession planning with DI, because I'm telling you, and this is so funny, we do a lot of business in life succession planning. And about a third of that comes with docs. Two-thirds of it doesn't come with any agreement at all. And DI, this is a whole new game when you think about DI succession planning. I don't know if I'm going to die with my partner, but I might be disabled with my partner. We'll get into that Wednesday. When we're talking about introducing people, there's so much. I mean, I'm looking at this as a plate. I'm looking at individual DI. I'm looking at group DI. I'm looking at short-term DI. I'm looking at long-term DI. I'm looking at business overhead expense. I'm looking at retirement planning. I fell off the floor last week, and I had many emails on this where Marcy says, yes, you could insure your retirement plan. I mean, I have to tell you, even I was shocked. That was new to me. So there's so many, there's quite a list here, a potpourri of things that we can actually talk about and introduce. So when you talk about it, like business overhead, and we're going to get into that tomorrow. We're going to unpack the whole thing, but business overhead is another one of those things where people go, I didn't know you could actually, for a disability, indemnify your expense loads for your company.
That's absolutely true. There are many producers out there that sell this product, work in the product segment, and they don't realize that there's an additional product out there that could really help business owners in the event they became sick or hurt and couldn't come back to work.
When I think about business overhead expense, it's so changed over the last decade. And I'm now seeing it where the place is, well, first of all, I'm assuming it's deductible.
Yes, it is.
Okay. When the benefits come back out, are they free?
So how that works is that premiums are tax deductible, benefits are taxable, but what do you do with the benefits? You turn around and you pay your expenses, which then becomes a deductible item.
So it becomes a revenue neutral, but actually still deductible and free at the end game because you're expensing it out.
That's right.
We're going to get into all this and tomorrow's show on business because I want you to unpack that and do a real good job on it. When I'm thinking about some of the things that we talk about indemnification through disability. Now, I've only named a few. Maybe you have others. I said retirement, business overhead, things of that nature. What else is available?
Well, we also have an indemnity plan where the indemnity was going to go, indemnification for a loan. So if the loan, you get disabled and you have an outstanding loan, what happens then is that that policy will actually come in and pay the bank that loan amount.
Well, now I'm talking about, I know about life insurance for loans, but now I'm talking about DI. We're going to have to get into that. When we come back from the break, we're going to continue our introduction into disability insurance for business, part of our disability insurance series with Dan. And don't forget to enroll in IULUniversity.com for the best training, education, and sales support when it comes to life insurance for retirement income.
You're listening to the insurance industry's number one resource for products, planning ideas, carrier information, and interviews you can use. When it comes to life insurance, annuities, long-term care, disability, or group pension plans, we're the news you can use.
Did you know the average 401k runs out of money just 7 to 8 years into retirement? Time Magazine, The Wall Street Journal, and many other publications have warned of the difficulty of saving with a 401k. But what if there was a way to create tax-free lifetime retirement income with no stock market risk? Good news, there is.
You know, living in fear of the next market dive is not the way I want to live my life.
Why would I go out there and take on risk when I don't need to?
I have a lot less stress knowing I can't lose any more of my retirement savings in the stock market.
Call now to receive your free, no-obligation analysis of what this retirement vehicle could do for you, a comparison to your current retirement plan, and a free video that explains this exciting opportunity. Start planning a retirement you can enjoy instead of worrying about future tax increases and stock market losses. Creating income that will last your entire life is the most important thing you'll ever do. Take control of your future. Call now for your free analysis, comparison, and video.
Well, welcome back to the Business Insurance Zone. I'm Steve Savant with Dan Stenerson. And let me tell you something. We're giving away all kinds of stat-packed information for DI. Just hop out to my website and I'll give it to you, thebiz.tv. And while you're out there, click on the Backroom Technician icon for 30-day free trial to access the best needs analysis and sales support material for financial planning. I've been using it for 22 years. I'm actually using some of the docs for this show. And before moving forward with anything that you hear on our show and all this week, Dan and I are going to be talking about that which is deductible and that which isn't, always check in with your tax advisor, and especially if you're FINRA licensed, your broker-dealer compliance department. We're talking about introducing you into business DI. I mean, really, Dan, when we're talking about it, I looked at these stats put out by a DI carrier, and if they would have paid the freight for this show, I'd have mentioned them. But I'm looking at this right now, and I'm looking at the several different diagnostic issues and the monthly benefit paid out to different people, whether it could be a plumber, it could be an accountant, it could be an attorney, a medical professional. I'm looking at the basic disability claims, what age were they when the policy was issued, and what was the actual age of their claim. I'm so surprised it can go from anywhere. I mean, some of these are pretty wide. This big one, that's 60, the dentist, because he had a brain injury, got $6,500 for all the way out till he was 65. I mean, I'm sorry, but that staggers the imagination. This guy was just being a dentist, he had an injury, and when that injury occurred, his DI claim, and I mean, for, and he was, it says here he was 57, so that paid it for 57 all the way out to 65.
Absolutely. And Steve, you're citing just one person.
Yeah, just one.
You know, the fact of the matter is that over 51 million Americans are actually disabled.
Wow. When I'm looking at 51 million, and I see this list has a, I mean, this is about, half this list is blue collar. And they're receiving, I mean, here's one $1,500, another one $700, another one $1,000, another one $800. Basic things like, hey, I'm a bookkeeper, right? And they couldn't do books anymore. All these areas, it shows the diagnostic. You say, Steve, I'd love to see those insurance claims. Just say, Steve, send me the DI insurance claim. I'll send you the page, and I'll just hop out to my site, thebiz.tv. Now, when I'm looking in there, think about all the things that we could sell on disability alone in a business. Now we've talked about, you know, key man, business succession, we've talked about retirement, and then you said something just before we came on the second segment that I wanted to kind of come back to.
Let's talk about that.
Loan, because that is weird. Now I understand when people go for big loans, they say, well, in case somebody dies, let's do a life insurance loan indemnification.
Right.
But now you're saying this is kind of, is it's new to me. Has it been that new?
Actually, the actual protection has been out there for a number of years, mm-hmm. perhaps maybe even two decades. The fact of the matter is, and the practicality of that, is when you're talking about dentists or physicians or other professionals that want to acquire a practice. Very often the bank will go ahead and make the loan in order for you to buy that practice, but they want that backed up with not only life insurance but a disability plan mm-hmm. in the event something should happen.
So when you're doing this, I'm thinking there's some financial issues. I need some financial and justification issues, right? I have to put out on the paper some kind of basic, what's the number we're trying to indemnify?
Yes.
Will they indemnify the entire loan? I mean, what's, is there caps to this?
Or they actually will. The carriers will take into consideration the principal amount of the loan plus the interest that goes on top of that loan. And they would cover that full amount over the term of the loan, and they would adjust it over time.
Now, this is, again, separate from individual DI that you may have on the principals.
That's correct.
Okay, so I just want to make sure I get this. So I can go ahead, now I'm identifying the loan, I'm indemnifying in business overhead expense, which we're going to talk about tomorrow.
Yep.
And this is still not in the same equation for the individual DI.
Yep.
So when we're looking at DI, it's bigger than just your paycheck, you know, protection.
That's right.
It's your, now we're in business land. We're in corporate land. We're now looking at firm indemnification on my expense loads, on my loans to the bank. And by the way, I'm just curious, because I just did about maybe, I'm gonna say 1, 2, 3 months ago, we did a life insurance and the banks didn't call for DI for the principals.
Yeah, very, very often the life insurance, will, the actual buyout document itself will not identify the disability provision in there. Some will, some won't. The actual stat is only 5% of all life insurance indemnified buyout documents have DI. 5%.
5%, and it seems to me that a bank, if they were doing their due diligence, especially on the loan provision on a financial basis alone, that they would pick up on this. Do you have to be the instructor here and kind of walk them through this?
Well, you would think that it would be more known to more producers in the marketplace, but the fact of the matter is that you're going to find some banks mm-hmm. that are going to require it. Other banks may not require that mm-hmm. when it comes to buy-sell.
Well, I'm suspicious that if the producers don't know it, I'm wondering if those banks that don't know it at all, there's an exposure here, because the likelihood of DI or a disability among these principals that they're on the hook for on the loan are much higher than their death.
And you know what's really strange about that is that most producers themselves, they'll see the provision in the buyout document that requires disability, but they fail to pursue that. And the reason for that is because they feel very uncomfortable with that product. Well, there's no need to feel uncomfortable, because there are resources out there that'll help those producers with that product.
That sounds like, if I knew that document and I was reading that as a life insurance producer and I saw DI was embedded in the agreement, wouldn't I have a fiduciary obligation to bring that to the table?
That's our feeling.
Yeah, because I think that's a monster E&O issue, because I read it, I knew it, and I only addressed the area of expertise, which would tell me another E&O issue, which is, if I don't have the expertise to talk about this, life or age, I can't do the thing at all.
Right.
Because I'm leaving one part of the equation out. The attorney's already addressed it.
Right. But the fact of the matter, aren't you exposing your E&O on all the products that you have there? The individual DI, the BOE, the buy sell, the indemnity? Yep.
Yeah, business succession insurance, whether it's buy, sell, cross purchase, stock redemption, or wait and see trust, needs to be applied not only to life, but Anitza replied all the issues of DI, and we're going to talk about them all this week. Remember, you can watch all our shows by going out to our site this week, all on DI at thebiz.tv. And you can follow me on Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, Pinterest, and Google+. That's the buzz on the biz for today. You've been in the zone, the business insurance zone.
You're listening to the insurance industry's number one resource for products, planning ideas, carrier information, and interviews you can use. When it comes to life insurance, annuities, long-term care, disability, or group pension plans, we're the news you can use.